dreaded ramp test. Jumping on Zwift tonight.
I'm gonna give this everything I've got.
Hi, my name's Thomas Martinez, and I've had a lot of hobbies over the years, but I fit in between my full-time job as a tattoo artist. But now, it's time for my journey into the pursuit of speed and adventure. I am the cycling tattooist.
So welcome to a very cold and frosty January morning. Now later on today, I've got the dreaded ramp test, but first things first, let's get the workday done. So that's me done for the day. On my way home now. It's 10 to 4. Sorry, people working 9 to 5s, don't get jealous. Finishing at a nice early time certainly does have its perks, especially back in the summer. It meant that I could get straight out on the bike after work. And I mean, there was times that I'd even do like a 100k ride after work and still get home before the sun went down. So yeah, it's like I say, it certainly has its perks. Unfortunately, we are still in the winter, so yeah, the days are short and I don't get that luxury right now. So I save myself going out in the cold and the dark. I'm gonna be jumping on Zwift tonight. And as I mentioned earlier, I'm gonna do something that I hate doing, and that's do a ramp test. Now, one of the reasons that I do want to do this ramp test today is I got speaking with some of the guys out on one of the social rides the other day, and we was having a bit of a debate about how accurate the ramp test is and how it compares to the 20-minute test. So that's going to be the main aim of the game for today, is seeing if the figures match up. I recently did a 20-minute test, so yeah, let's see how I get on the ramp test. Anyways, let's get back and jump on Zwift. Right, so after a lot of faffing around, I'm on the bike, and yeah, let's get this ramp test done. So for any of you that are not familiar with Zwift, I'm gonna just show you. You go into your training here, and then I'm already in it, but under FTP tests, you've got FTP test. FTP test, a short one, ramp test and ramp test light. So we're going for the ramp test one. Click workout. And then I've just selected the map we're gonna use is the Wandering Flats in the Macquarie Islands. And then we just hit ride. So yeah, the first part of this is just a 5-minute warm up. And then as you can see, on the left hand side of the screen there, you've got minute intervals basically, and it's going to increase at 20 watts each minute. And the idea behind a ramp test is you're just hanging on for as long as you possibly can, and then as if by some sort of magic, they'll work out your FTP based on your performance. So I'm just spinning over nice and easy on the warm up here. Because it's stepping up, you're getting your warm up in during the effort as well, which is kind of a good thing about the ramp test. Whereas with your proper FTP 20-minute one, you have to make sure you're fully warmed up for that, because it's a hard 20-minute effort. So and you have to be really good with your pacing. So yeah, if you're not good at figuring out what you can hold for 20 minutes, this is definitely a better option. So as I mentioned earlier, I'm just a little bit skeptical
about the accuracy of the ramp test. So I've done a 20 minute test 2 weeks ago now, and that came out that I had an FTP of 328. Hopefully we should be seeing the same result. I can't imagine I've got any stronger in 2 weeks, and let's hope I haven't lost any as well. But yeah, I've got 20 seconds now until the intervals start. Obviously starting off super easy at 100 watts, and you'll find for at least the first sort of half, you're gonna find it relatively easy. In fact, too easy. As you're seeing right now, it's actually really hard to hold 100 watts. Now, I've just put erg mode on. Somebody told me that's the way to do this test, because then at least that way you're just holding the same cadence, and then it will figure out the power for you, because it's a smart trainer, so it just basically adds the power on. It's just a little bit easier than trying to balance the power and the cadence at the same time. But you definitely find that these lower sort of lower end of the power, it's definitely going to be a lot harder to hold it consistent, because your body naturally wants to produce more power than that. So it's just sort of, you know, you're just kind of ticking over. So yeah, just trying to find the rhythm at the minute. I'm sitting about 80-85 RPM, probably a little bit too slow, but yeah, as we start getting up into power, then I'll probably bring that up a little bit. Now, whilst things are still relatively easy and I can still talk pretty well, there was one thing that I did want to say about this test. So FTP is one of those touchy sort of subjects. Some people think it really matters, and other people don't really worry about it at all. But I think it's a nice way to sort of gauge your progress, and especially for me, as some of you might know, I only started taking road cycling seriously just over a year ago now. Maybe about a year and a half ago or so. And since then, I've made some pretty good progress. I believe my FTP when I started was around about the 250 mark, which some might argue is high already. So I was quite lucky, I did start off at a good point. But yeah, I've made some good progress. And yeah, like I said, currently we're at 328. Now, one of my goals this year is, after last year getting involved with the crit racing scene and doing some TTs as well, I definitely want to get involved more with that. So, you know, trying to get a bigger FTP is never going to be a bad thing. Obviously I'm not completely focusing on that, especially with the crit racing. You know, racecraft is definitely a big thing of that, but you know, getting some more power under your belt is never a bad thing, for sure. So currently I'm weighing in at about 72 kilograms, which puts me around the 4.5 watts per kilo mark. So having said that, one of my goals this year is going to be to try and achieve the 5 watts per kilo mark, which is definitely achievable, but not without some hard work. So I'm definitely going to be having to get into the realms of 350 watts FTP, and maybe get back down to my race weight. But I'm definitely going to be focusing more on trying to get some more power under the belt rather than shedding off weight, because, you know, I don't think it's a very healthy thing worrying about your weight too much. But yeah, anyway, as you can tell, I'm starting to get a little bit out of breath now. So this, get my head down and get stuck into this. We're currently sitting at 240 watts. Just about to go into the next one, which is obviously gonna be 260 watts. And then, yeah, we'll just keep going from there, see how far we can get. I think last time I done one of these, I made it to the 440 mark, so yeah, let's see if we can get further today. I'm gonna give this everything I've got. So I apologize now for the faces I'm gonna put. Do a little warm down now to make up a little bit of extra time. Yeah, pretty happy with that effort. You always know you've gone harder and you can taste blood. So yeah, as I was saying before, the goal for this year is 5 watts per kilo. Whether that's achievable or not, I guess we'll have to wait and see. But so yeah, based on that test just then, that brings me out at 4.54 watts per kilo. So, you know, it's pretty respectable, I would say, but a little bit of extra power wouldn't hurt, would it? So realistically, if we said I stayed at the same weight, 72 kilograms, times that by 5, is 360 watt FTP we're gonna have to be aiming for. I don't think that's completely unachievable. We're talking about finding an extra 35 watts, so fingers crossed. Wish me luck. Gonna have to be putting in a lot of effort this year, I tell you that.
So thanks very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.